I'm letting everyone know that I will be eating healthy this week. It's just a small brownie. So me eating that brownie didn't really match what I stated about my plan to eat healthy this week. So today, on Brief Brain Facts, we're taking a look at the contradictions we make, resulting in cognitive dissonance, and the brain regions involved in maintaining inconsistent beliefs or performing contradictory acts. Decisions. We make them every day. What will I eat for breakfast? What shirt am I going to wear for this recording of Brief Brain Facts? Well, what happens if I'm presented with two equally desirable options, such as a white t-shirt or a black t-shirt? How do I justify choosing the black shirt over the white shirt? I guess I decided I liked the black shirt better, clearly. The attempt at squaring up or rationalizing our decisions when presented with equally desirable options may be an attempt at reducing cognitive dissonance. Cognitive dissonance is the uncomfortable feeling caused by keeping inconsistent beliefs or acting in a contradictory way. These inconsistencies may cause people to change their beliefs, assuring that there is no longer a mismatch between beliefs and or action, thus maintaining cognitive consistency. For example, someone who has a dog may be adamant about cleaning up after their dog's potty breaks, until they fail to act on their belief. Maybe it rains, and they decide not to clean up after their pet. This goes against their belief, so they justify it by saying, or thinking, it's raining right now, otherwise I would have picked it up. These justifications are an attempt to reduce that discomfort or cognitive dissonance induced by the conflict between their actions, they didn't clean up after their own dog, and their beliefs, must always clean up after your pet. Cognitive dissonance was identified in the 1950s, and thanks to technological advancements in brain imaging, researchers have identified areas in the brain associated with cognitive dissonance, as well as areas in the brain involved in alleviating disharmony between contradictory beliefs or actions, resulting in cognitive consistency. But before we talk about those specific brain areas, let's learn a bit more about the thing in our heads, not the disturbing thoughts about the heat death of the universe, but our brains. Let's think of our brain as a three-dimensional puzzle. As such, our brain consists of two major sections, the cerebrum and the cerebellum. The cerebellum is responsible for things like balance, coordination, and even memory. The cerebrum is the part of the brain responsible for integrating all of our senses so that we can interact with our environment more effectively, as well as things like judgment, planning, and language. Looking more closely at the cerebrum, this part of the brain can be puzzled together based on functional specialization or areas of the brain that perform specific tasks. Check out our video on the five main structures of the brain. Now that we have a better understanding of the brain, let's direct our attention to the frontal lobes. The frontal lobes are responsible for higher order processing and executive functioning, things like judgment, planning, and making decisions. We're getting a bit technical now, but bear with me, there's a reason. When we look at the brain, including the frontal lobes, some areas of the brain are referenced based on their location. The side outer view of the brain is considered the lateral view, while the side inner view of the brain is considered the medial view. The upper view of the brain is considered the dorsal or superior view, while the lower view of the brain is considered a ventral or inferior view. Finally, towards the front of the brain is considered the anterior or rostral portion of the brain, and towards the back is unsurprisingly called the posterior or caudal portion of the brain. Understanding brain directionality, we note that the frontal lobes are located towards the front, anterior portion of the brain. Based on brain imaging studies, cognitive dissonance, the uncomfortable feeling produced from the clash between conflicting ideas or contradictory behaviors, involves the frontal lobes, particularly the posterior portion of the medial frontal cortex, or the PMFC. This area of the brain is associated with aversion and choice justification. According to researchers, the PMFC activates when actions are put into conflict with beliefs. In a study designed to further investigate the role of the PMFC in cognitive dissonance, researchers showed a causal link between the PMFC activation and the change in attitude designed to alleviate cognitive dissonance. In this study, the researchers created cognitive dissonance by having participants rate their preference of two wallpapers and then reevaluate their choice upon viewing the wallpaper for a second time. Some participants determined that they had rejected their preferred wallpaper, while other participants had actually chosen their least favorite wallpaper. Using transcranial magnetic stimulation, a non-invasive technique designed to cause electrical currents to flow in targeted areas of the brain using magnets, to decrease activity in the PMFC, the researchers decreased the participants' attitude changes, thus diminishing their need for cognitive consistency. However, the PMFC isn't the only area associated with cognitive dissonance. Another implicated area includes the insula, a small area associated with a lot of things, such as craving, empathy, disgust, and decision-making. thinking, among various other things. This area may be involved with the emotional aspect of cognitive dissonance, particularly negative emotions such as anxiety or anger. The final area of the brain associated with cognitive dissonance is the dorsolateral prefrontal cortex, or the DLPFC, an area of the brain associated with cognitive control. In a study, researchers disrupted the activity of the DLPFC and discovered that diminishing activity in this area of the brain resulted in a reduction of choice rationalization brought about by cognitive dissonance. Researchers showed a brain response in both producing cognitive dissonance and choice rationalization once a decision had been made. Importantly, cognitive dissonance is not necessarily an unhealthy response. In fact, it does allow people to change beliefs and feel okay with their decisions, especially if a difficult decision needed to be made. Thus, cognitive dissonance allows us all to not be crippled by the choices that we make. Do you have some examples of people exhibiting cognitive dissonance? If so, comment below. If you like what you saw, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching.